going to discuss about Sarpadosh. Snake deity worship started from very earlier time, very ancient time. The Sarpa, it's known as Sarpas, Nagas, snakes. Actually, it is representing the Kundalini problems, Sarpadosha. Not a different something. The problem of psyche actually. Kundalini is the sexual energy. Above Swadhisthana Chakra, we call this energy as spiritual energy. You can check the book of Arthur Avalon, Mr. George Woodruff, his famous book, The Serpent Power. The Kundalini will run through the wrong nadis, it will create so many problems. These are known as Sarpadoshas actually. In astrological chart, you can see the Rahu and Kedu. The Kedu is the Sahasrara, Rahu is the Muladhara. That's why the Kedu is a representative of the Sannyasa also. See, when it will run through the Ida and Pingala in a wrong way, then it will create the problems. So it will control the archetypes. It will change the archetypes. Archetypes means here the subconscious figures which is emitting negative or positive energy. It will turn the energy as negative or positive. Because of the wrong Kundalini running, may feel different problems like the problem in the breathing. Breathing is everything. If you can take fast breathing, lifespan will decrease. Our biological changes will come, the adrenaline will come, emotions will change, the anger, violence, everything. When we will be in anger or violence, naturally we will take speed breathing pattern. So, the anxiety, everything will come. The anxiety or OCD, obsessive compulsive disorder, cause some kind of childhood abuse. Then the Kundalini will activate in wrong path. This is actually the Sarpadosha. Our brain and the skin is very connected. Our skin tissues developed from brain. It is directly connected. That's why if we have some tension, we will do like this. So itching sensations are coming from kind of mental stress. Many times. So the color changes or skin, other skin problems may happen by the Sarpadosha, means the wrong awakening of Kundalini. It will create many mental issues. Then naturally the marriage may not happen or family life will be collapsed. So naturally, the sexual intercourse will not be successful, so the children may not come. Fertility problems are coming because of this Rahu or Kundalini Sarpadosha. Naturally, the karmas will also collapse, maybe in the career life will be collapse, family life will be collapse, maybe the chances will be there. So this is actually we have to take like that. But people, normally many people are going to temples, in snake temples, and doing offerings. But it is good because some kind of negative energy of this kind of negative energy can suck by the external imagery of the positive imagery of the snake. Then the subconscious negative imagery will come to outside like projective technique in psychology, ink bolt test, some kind of like that. Some external imagery can bring out some subconscious negative imagery to outside. These temples are supporting for that one. It is good, but it is not for the solution for all of our problems. counseling is needed, some kind of psychoanalysis or CBT, cognitive behavior therapy is needed, some kind of medicines are needed for some issues. So everything is not merely the belief problem, but many cases are like that. But we have to understand separately. Example, breathing problem may come by the problem of lungs, but if we are believing this is from the Sarpa Dosha, then we are doing the offerings in temples, but it will not be clear. The issue will be continue. So we have to understand sometimes the astrology will collapse the life of the people sometimes, because some aspect is very good, but some aspect it is creating the laziness, or our success will go to, responsibility will go to some other planets or something. We are interested to hear the problems are happening by some other issues of other people or some other planets. Our ego will be happy. But that ego satisfaction will create more issues, because whenever I can finish, clear my issues, then only I can develop. The responsibility should come to me. Then only I can clear my issues and go ahead. The most difficult task in psychology to convince a person the problems are happening by himself. So these kind of astrological blind beliefs will create more issues, more task, more effort. We have to put more effort to convince a person, an astrology believer, to clear the issues, to understand the problem of himself. So it is very difficult. So we have to understand the reality. The problems and solution is in our hand. Don't give the power to decide our life to planet positions. We have to give the power to our deity, Upasana Murti. If you have belief in deity, we have to give the power to God. He can clear everything. We have to believe, then it will happen. The magics happen. The manifestation will happen. But the astrology have its own relevance and importance. We have to use astrology to understand the psychological archetypes in subconscious mind, how it is working, which are the archetypes are negative. We have to understand that. For that, the people cannot say that. We have to understand. For that, we can use astrology positively to understand the problems. For correct diagnosis, it will be helpful in psychologically. But the solutions we have to do by the worship of deity. Many different meditation practices are very helpful for this one. So we have to do the meditations to run Kundalini through the Sushumna. A proper sadhana is the solution for that one. Proper meditation is the solution for that one. Shivan.